Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, my name is Georgia, and this, if you are a returning viewer, you will know that this is Gabby. This is your fourth video now, isn't it, Gabby?
Yeah.
I know, you're becoming like a repeat guest. It makes it sound a lot better than how I said it. But yeah, this is Gabby. Today I thought I would... So yeah, today I thought I would do a video. Well, I didn't think of it, my dad did. I would do this for my dad because he apparently used to watch this show when he was young and he loved it, and he was like, please react to Al Bundy's best insults. So that's what we're doing today. We're reacting to Al Bundy's best insults. Now, I'm pretty sure the program's called like Married with Kids. Married with Children.
Yeah. Married with Kids sounds...
Yeah. I mean, so yeah, this is what we're actually doing today. So yeah, let's get on with the video. This is for you, Dad. Married? The children.
With kids songs.
Yeah, Al's best insults.
Excuse me, but am I invisible?
Possibly from Pluto. Oh, please. Before, the car costs more than the car. More than the condom I should have used the night you were conceived.
You imagine if your dad would turn around and said that to you after you made a joke. No. Wait, what did he say?
Honey,
go back.
Oh, honey.
Oh, that looks... Okay, are you ready? Just want to hear what he said. It went a bit quick, didn't it?
I want a blue.
Honey, why don't you just stay home and bowl me over?
Peg, I prefer a place where my balls are returned promptly. Well, Mercy, congratulations. I didn't know you were expecting.
Oh, it's just...
It must have expected.
There's a lot of fat jokes in this. You're not allowed to make fat jokes anymore. This is something that's not allowed. Isn't it? Imagine if, like, nowadays, if you ever watched a show like this and that was said in it, the outrage.
Yeah. Yeah, you don't really get shows like this anymore.
No, you don't.
There's like a certain era of television where there's shows like this.
And now it's like, don't make fat jokes. You would literally get hate if you made a fat joke.
Bended my foot.
And I see you must have fallen on your butt a time or two.
Touching, honey. Now rub my feet.
Hey, I wouldn't
have a tank of gas.
I'm not
worried
about that.
But my tank, and you go, what did he say?
My car's only got half a tank of gas.
To be fair, it's a creative insult, but it's a bit savage. Like, imagine you're going to a shop to try on shoes, and someone says that to you. That's so true, though. It's like, say it to my face. Oh no, it's like the opposite thing, isn't it? Of like, you didn't have to say it to my face. Most people are like, say it to my face, but she was like, yeah, but you have to say it to my face.
How dare you say that to my face?
You'll never guess what Jefferson did!
Misunderstood your cries of pluck me to the butcher.
Girl, I wanted to be a ballerina.
Ballerina? Sure are my nutcracker.
I have just about had enough of you.
Well, you wouldn't say that if I came with fries and a medium drink.
No, look at her face. She's like,
I'm gonna kill you.
I'm gonna slap you so hot.
You know, medium, the size between small and you.
Why must you always be so negative?
Why did you cross the road? Natural-born salesman.
Excuse me.
Hey, do I come to the hag shop bother you when you're working?
Good. Now you can put your metal plate.
Next, if I ever get a job, I'm gonna do that. Shopkeeper comes upstairs. I'm like, do I ever bother you? Why are you bothering me?
Back in your head. Although that's a lot like putting a lid on an empty jar.
Did you hear that? Ah! Because I just want to see someone goes like, your mom, you're like, ah!
Or a bra on you.
Question two. Who would you rather spend the night with? A, your wife, or B?
B. Out front and be a little drummer boy.
Yes, I'm proud of myself. That's like me resting. I go, I'm like, can we was that funny? No, but that's the thing. It's like, I don't shy away from insulting people, but this is like savage.
Yeah.
Going? Aren't you open?
Oh, they're torn.
Pardon, ma'am, but unlike your mouth, we occasionally close. Just a second here. Now, why don't you just book out of here?
She's a blue.
We'll stand you in front of a mirror. I'll begin strangling you. When you reach the shade of blue that is satisfying to you, you yell moo and I'll stop.
That's it. I'm taking my business elsewhere.
No, that's the thing. It's like they think they're like, do you remember, like, people respond like that, thinking they're being so clever, like. It's like the whole whatever thing.
Yeah.
It's like when someone insults you, and like you insult them, and they're like, oh, whatever. Like they think,
yay.
She's like, I'll just say my business elsewhere, as if it's like the best comeback.
Jenny Craig.
Hi, honey. Did you miss me?
With every bullet so far.
Wow, nice wheels. But you have to realize, stealing cars is a felony.
So it's pretend to be that kid on Home Improvement.
Do you know what I reckon? Whoever directed this show either has some a lot of pent up anger,
yeah.
Or I don't know, maybe his wife divorced him and now he's like, oh my god.
Yeah, some of the writers get a bit personal.
With this attitude, you're gonna be working here for the rest of your life.
Well, take a gander into the seat next to you if you want to see what your future looks like.
Come, Penelope. Let's go someplace where they treat us with respect.
No!
You know, Marcy, how can you be so unfeeling? Didn't you ever get up in the morning and suddenly realize that something very, very important was gone? Well, sure you do. You must every morning when you open up your pajama top. Well, let me... It's just like an elevator. There's a 2-ton weight limit in this.
Some people just don't have it.
Let's say I nail the soles directly to your feet. It'll give you more traction when you're pulling the ice wagon.
You'll be hearing from my attorney.
Is that the law offices of Hagen and Dobbs? You know, Jefferson, good for you. You decided to take the Miller
board. They're quite funny to be fair, but you just want to be like, ha 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 ha, do you know what I mean?
I had steak tonight. What are you having?
If I was the mailman, I'd be having your wife.
I smell foul.
You certainly do.
Isn't that such a classic dad joke?
Yeah.
That's such a dad thing to
my
say.
Son. Oh, I'm trying to get an all over tan.
You're asking a lot of the sun.
Excuse me, do you have any pumps in my size?
Yes, I do, but the Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Shoes would not allow me to sell them.
Well, I hope you get coal in your stocking on Christmas morning.
And I hope you get slim fast in yours. Now, we're about to have our Christmas party here, so would you mind eggnogging on out?
Imagine they went to an audition, right, for this show, and they were like, yeah, we've got the perfect character for you, and you were just getting, like a fat joke aimed at you.
You'd be like, oh,
are you trying to say something?
Say it to my face.
You could have just said it to my face.
And to help you out, I made a top 10 list of things that make you more attractive for your, for your sex symbol husband.
Uh-oh.
Number
10, wear traditional Islamic garb covering all but the eyes. Number 9, feather removing electrolysis. Number 8, ski mask. Number 7, sew up holes in ski mask. Number 6, hire attractive woman to stand in front of you at all times. Number 5, beat job. Number 4, put paper bag over ski mask.
Number 3, just cover yourself completely and don't speak. Perfect woman.
Learn to walk backwards.
I'm gonna make a list for you, Bethany. How I can be more attractive.
Eyes of every man on earth.
Nice. Stop. Oh, I'm a 10 out of 10. I can't have no list. There's no list for me.
Ah, Peg.
Man of the century.
Better if I told you I needed you.
Yes, it would.
I think that's it.
I'm Taylor and this is Rumpus.
Hello, I'm Taylor and this is Rumpus. Piss off, Taylor. I always get plenty of Taylor in adverts. That was it. I mean, our just faces the whole time were just, yeah.
A little bit was quite silent because we were just like,
it's just stuff, it's just a lot of fat jokes. Either like the director is really fat and he was like, let's just make a bunch of fat jokes and make fun of it. Or yeah. He's like got something against fat girls. I don't know.
I guess fat jokes can be quite easy to make.
Yeah, they are the easiest jokes. She's like, you're fat. This is like the this is like the creative way of calling someone fat, isn't it? Yeah. I mean, I like that, but I mean the fact that like this is what my dad used to watch when he was young makes like now we know why he's the way he is. So when he was growing up on this, do you know what I mean?
Oh, you're fat. At least it's creative. Do you know what
it
I mean?
It is creative. It's just a creative way. And it's such a typical dad, isn't it? It's like the typical dad, but over-enhanced. Like, it's like they just were like, let's just make the typical dad, but just make him really over the top.
But imagine if you could think of those kind of insults like on the spot.
I know, I just
I'd be proud of myself.
I would too, I'd be like, I'd be like, but yeah, that was our reaction. Kind of reaction, in this time we're just like but yeah, that was our reaction to that video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up, please subscribe, and please turn on the notification bell. The notification. I know you're about to say it. But yeah. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!